Good morning and a warm welcome to One and All present here. Now we start with a prayer song. Prayer should be the key in the morning and the lock at night. I now invite Vijayashri and Nityashri of 2nd MCOM to invoke God's blessing through prayer song.
Namo Ariyantanam, Namo Siddhanam, Namo Ayariyanam. Namo Vajayanam, Namo Loye Savasahunam, Eso Panchanamo Karo, Sava Pavapanasano, Mangalanam Chesavesim, Padamam Havai Mangalam, Padamam Havai Mangalam. Nirarum kadaludatta nilamadandi kililulugum Sirarum badanamena tigalparada kandamidil Tikkanamum adisiranda dravidanal tirunadum Takkasira pirenudalum daritanarum tilagamume Attilaga vasani polani tulagumin bamura Yetti sayum bugal manaka irinda perun tamilanange Tamilanange Unsi dilamai tirambiyand sayar marand Vaartu dume
No beauty shines better than that of a good heart. I now call upon Monica H. of 1st MCOM to present the welcome address.
Knowledge has beginning but no end. Good morning and warm greetings to one and all present here. On behalf of Sri Shankar Lal Sundaribai Sashun Jain College and PG and Research Department of Commerce, I extend a very sincere warm welcome to our Principal Dr. S. Padmavati Ma'am, Vice Principal Dr. S. Rukmani Ma'am, HOD Dr. C.K. Deepa Ma'am, and also extend a note of thanks to our resource person, Dr. A.V. Biju. Thank you, sir, for taking your presence time out and presenting our attending our workshop. Dr. Biju is currently working as assistant professor in Department of Commerce in School of Business Management and Legal Studies, University of Kerala. Sir has completed his MCOM Finance in University of Kerala, MBA Finance in Indira Gandhi National Open University, LLB in University of Kerala, PhD in University of Kerala, Clare National Internship Tata Institute of School Science, Summer School Program IIM Indore, Certified Stock Exchange Trainer Program, National Stock Exchange Mumbai, selected for Clare Program for Foreign Country, Research and Paper Presentation. Sir has industrial experience in certified trainer of National Stock Exchange, certified by NSE, financial consultant for several private clients, research consultant for project assistance. Sir has also done 25 articles in peer-reviewed journals. Sir has also published 8 books relating to business studies, investment management, risk management, and derivatives. I feel privileged in welcoming you, sir, and hope you enjoy this session. Thank you.
Thank you for the introduction speech. And good morning to all. I thank SSS Shasan Jain College for Women and IQSE office bearers. Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
PG and Research Department of Commerce. I especially thank Dr. C.K. Deepa and Ms. Divya Devi who take initiatives for giving me the opportunity. So good morning again. So shall I start my session?
Yes, sir.
Okay. The topic which was given to me is literature reviews. So why review of literature? So everybody doing research should undergo this process, but I don't know how many of the scholars giving preference or giving importance to this process. This is a must for thesis, but I think many of the scholars taking a minor importance to this review of literature, but a lack of review of literature will lead for the wrong conclusions, and your study may be biased because of it. So that this process is very vital in research. So today's session, I am focusing on the review of literature and the importance of review of literature, and how effective way we can conduct the review of literature. And I also focus on some review papers, conceptual papers and those journals in which these papers can be published. Subject advances the worth or value of subject is based on the findings of prior studies. So the worth or value of subject is based on the findings of prior studies. If we are doing research, and we should consider the past 20 years studies at least. We should give more emphasis on the past 10 years studies at least. And these studies findings are very important part that findings will give a path for the development of constructs, for the development of variables, for the framing of hypothesis, etc. So we can do like a pool similar findings of past studies together to form a conclusion so that the researcher can fix a roadmap of his or her study. So in this process, we have to pool similar findings of past studies together to form a conclusion so that the researcher can fix a roadmap. So otherwise, a researcher cannot get a proper path, cannot get a proper variables because of lack of this process. So if we have some findings opposite directions of your work are to be set apart. There are findings which are connected with your work. There are findings which are not connected with your work. There are findings which say opposite of your direction. So you can set apart those findings. So this process is very important. This slide emphasis on the importance of review of literature. Most important purpose of review of literature. If you don't work on previous literature, this is very essential. This is very important. If you don't work on previous literature, you may miss the main variables from, you may miss some of the main variables from your research and may lead for the wrong conclusions. Finally, someone who have expertise in the field finds some disqualifications of your work and you may be questioned in the open defense or evaluation process. So be careful. So recently we have seen so many research evaluation process, open defenses, and the main problem by the students, they couldn't undertake a very good literature review process or effective literature review process, so that the main variables some of the main variables, crucial variables, they might have experienced or they might not experienced, they have missed from the findings. So that time we cannot do anything. So many criticisms from the expert that you should have taken this kind of variable, this variable, that variable, something like that. But the thing is, we have to hear all these criticisms no other way. So we should be careful in the beginning that in the literature review process, we have to consider all the important elements in connection with the work. So have you able to understand my lecture? If any queries, you can just ask me, intervene and just ask. Okay, am I audible?
Yes, sir, you're audible, sir.
Okay. So most important purpose of literature review, if you don't work on previous literature, this is already taken. So present status of research, reason for dilution of quality. So recent assessment by the professors on the quality diminution of research in the universities, the major reason is the lack of serious literature reviews. Scholars concentrate more on the data analysis through softwares without understanding the story or background information of their present topic. So this is happening everywhere. Scholars are giving more importance to the softwares and data analytics without understanding the story behind this concept they are doing. That is very pathetic condition. The thing is, we have to take more importance to the review, because that's the journals are also expecting this kind of thing. The theory is more important than the analytics. Okay. There are literature review based journals, you know, that you might have experienced. There are some journals, they only publish review papers. So I can show you some good journals. One of the journals is International Journal of Management Reviews. This is published by British Academy. I can show you. This is a journal, International Journal of Management Review. And this journal purely published the review papers. You can submit the review papers. You can access some of the open access papers here. I can show you one paper. It's purely based on. You can get the PDF of this paper. So this is a type of review paper. This is fully written based on literature reviews. So this paper is about philanthrocapitalism. And you can see that this method using the citation analysis. And you can see the number of publications they have included, the number of scholarly publications per year discussing philanthrocapitalism at the end of 2019. Okay, so this analytics we can get from the citation analysis. I will show you in the later part of my presentation. So everything based on the researchers done on the basis of on the topic of philanthrocapitalism. And finally, they have this is a journal who take part in the topic of philanthrocapitalism. A number of publications comes in the journals. That's all details which is shown in the paper. Okay. So, everything based on the previous research studies of this concept, philanthrocapitalism. Okay. So you can also make this kind of paper and publish it, but it is not a simple task. Okay, this is a Wiley journal. And this is the Journal of Economic Literature. This is a very important, very, very important journal in economics. This journal should be referred by the people who are in the area of finance. all the review means major reviews which comes in this journal as papers. This journal also publishes only review papers, not empirical papers. So what are the purpose of literature reviews? To provide a new idea or direction, act as a base for development of hypothesis. Nowadays we can see that there are hypotheses set by the scholars without knowing the theory. Simply they state that null hypothesis, there is no difference, there is no relationship, but there is, of course, there is a relationship in the theory, but still they are stating null hypothesis. And so many null hypotheses we can see from the thesis, like hundreds of null hypotheses. This is a very, very rubbish phenomenon which is happening in the research. So instead of doing recycled research, so we can understand what is recycled researches. Recycled researches means some topic which has been job satisfaction of, for example, job satisfaction of college teachers, and the same job satisfaction of higher secondary teachers, same job satisfaction of school teachers. This is called recycled researches. Okay, then job commitment of commercial bank, job commitment of cooperative bank. The same repeated recycled researches or our research areas. So we can avoid this type of recycled researches, and we can go for a review paper or conceptual paper, provide a conceptual understanding to the readers. So that would be more great as compared to doing of these recycled researches. The same structural equation model in job satisfaction, structural equation model in commitment, structural equation model in motivation. Is that is fine? Or so we have to do a thing like we can have a conclusion of the concepts researched, and this conclusion can be open to the public, so that we have concluded that research is conducted over a period of time in the area of this concept, and this is for the reference. That way we can enlighten the public. So this way the review papers or literature reviews are focusing on. So in thesis also we can see some errors in literature review, just simply stated some of the literature. There is no connections. So we have to have a thematic review of literature based on the objectives. So multiple regression model again and again. So a lot of technology-driven models are included in the thesis without understanding the story or background information. That is, again, to be criticized. Scope of reviews, what methods to be adopted? So we can have different methods. What methods we can stick on it? What methods to be adopted, and what constructs are to be fixed for future researchers? Are the goal of review papers or literature review chapters in the thesis or dissertations? So we can have different methods. Out of the methods, which methods are better, or what constructs are to be suitable for our research? This can be evolved through literature review process. So you can search on the Google Scholar that other review papers published or not. If you take a concept, this philanthropic capitalism, it's a concept, and you can search it on the Google Scholar, and you can find that if any review paper pop up after your search, then you may go out of this concept. You can have a new concept every time when you try to publish a review paper. The same, already we have a review paper based on a concept. Then you can leave from that concept and you can take a new concept which do not have a review paper. So then also we can look on the 10 years back, a review paper has been published based on the concept. Then you can find that recent 10 years, there is no papers. Then you can go for the recent 10 years. The same concept can be repeated through a review paper. Okay. This is the goal of reviews. So methodology of reviews. Journal selection criteria is important. So we have a lot of journals which include pirated journals, clone journals, UGC CARE listed journals, Web of Science journals and Scopus journals, APDC journals. Okay, many journal indexes. So out of these, which index are dependable for taking data of data for the preparation of a review paper or literature review? So you remember, journals are your sample. In an empirical paper, the respondents, individuals are your samples. But in the review paper, journals are your samples. So journals criteria is very important. So you can have the criteria like this. You can take the Web of Science, and you can the other criteria, impact factor 1+ or above, that papers should be considered. The papers which published in journals which less than impact factor 1 should not be considered. Then ABS 2 or above, UK Business School list, you can consider the papers published in these journals. Then ABDC, A star or B papers, you can count for the purpose of review of literature. Scopus is like an ocean of journals. So you can take a quality criteria and while considering the journals listed in the Scopus. So I can see some thesis which have reviewed and literature review consists of a lot of local papers. This is not to be repeated. So when you do the literature review, you should consider the standard journals papers only, not the cloned pirated papers. I mean, in business news, news from the website, that should be avoided. So this is a journal base or index you can take while reviewing purpose, while preparing review purpose. EBSCOhost, Emerald Insight, Google Scholar, JSTOR, Procast, Sage Journals, Science Direct, Scopus, Springer Link, Taylor and Francis, Wiley, Online Library and Web of Science. These are the standard publishers and journal indexes. You can use this only. So you should be avoided the other pirated journals. So article search criteria. See, when you start to write a review paper, definitely you will search previous articles. So you can have your keywords. That means, for example, integrated reporting. So integrated reporting is a keyword. And you can search those keywords in Google Scholar or Web of Science or Scopus, whatever it is. Other way, you can do a citation analysis based on the keywords. So the citation analysis help you to concentrate in a particular area. So how you can use the citation analysis? Well, so I will show you the citation analysis in detail. So what is citation analysis? Citation pattern analysis is an important component for measuring research performance of the author. So many authors you may experience, and so many papers, and you have to check the performance of the authors through the citation analysis. And co-citation analysis has been used as an effective method to find citation pattern analysis, but it does not take co-occurrence analysis among authors. So there are citation analysis, co-citation analysis, co-occurrence analysis, different analysis. You can find papers based on all these things. So you can do a paper with citation analysis. You can do a paper in co-citation analysis. You can do a paper in co-occurrence analysis. Okay. So every based on different concepts, you can conduct research on the citation analysis as well as co-citation analysis. So what is citation? You know citation. Citation is the way you tell your readers that certain materials in your work came from another source. So you can see different citation styles. APA styles. So you are following the APA style, but different universities follow different styles. Medical association following different style of citation. The number of academic publications is increasing at a rapid pace, and it is unfeasible to remain everything that has been published. So a lot of publication you have experienced that it is unfeasible to remain everything that has been published. So that there is a review paper is there. If we read the review paper, you will understand. You will understand what is the core, what about the core areas in which the research has been conducted, who are the main authors, who are the core authors, and what about their countries, what about their affiliations, etc. You may understand after reading a citation-based paper. So now people are interested to read citation-based papers because they will get more information rather than the empirical papers. Okay. So the emphasis on empirical papers by the researchers has resulted in fragmented research teams. This hampers the ability to accumulate knowledge. Therefore, literature reviews are increasingly assuming a crucial role in synthesizing past research findings for the effective use of existing knowledge base. So these are the objectives of citation analysis. Everything, these objectives we can be available or get after citation analysis. Average citations per year, authors' production of work, most relevant sources, authors' impact. I will show you a citation analysis, and after that you will get it understand. These kind of things are the outcomes of citation analysis. Key terminologies, there are new terminologies, load cost laws, which will be the outcome of citation analysis. There are papers fully based on this load cost law alone. Shows that the relationship between number of authors and publications, co-authorship and co-occurrence is already discussed. These are the key terminologies discussing in this citation analysis. First of all, you have to understand what is bibliometric analysis. Or what is bibliometric data? That is the essentiality of doing this kind of thing. And what are keywords? So keywords, we should be careful about the keywords. If the keywords are wrong, you will be misdirected. So that we should be careful about the keywords while searching the journal database. Then scientific literature are to be analyzed. Okay, so these are the, because lack of time, I cannot be able to explain all these things. So understand the topic and field. In the review paper also, you should define your theoretical framework of the topic, and specifically the context and limitations of your research topic. Construct your definition. Set the scope of your research, define the research questions, kind of purpose published in the related field. So this, you should have a clear idea on this. And the research methodology. So here the samples are journals and journal papers. So if you have only 20 papers, no need to go bibliometric research. You will not get anything out of that. If the concept is very new, and you are going to publish a paper based on the bibliometric analysis, and it should not be possible because only 20 papers are available. You will not get a citation network based on this 20 papers. If you search in some keywords, you will get 50,000 papers or 10,000 papers because of it is been over researched. There are many empirical papers and conceptual papers based on this concept. So that you can go for the bibliometric analysis. Of course, it is possible to do the bibliometric analysis. Then 1,000 papers, confidently go for that. Then at least 300 papers would be fine. Go for the bibliometric analysis. So what do you want a citation analysis? A lot of other methods there to publish papers. Empirical papers, conceptual papers, review papers, bibliometric, papers are there. So why you're particularly interested in citation analysis? That should be written in the citation paper itself. why you are doing this citation-based paper on this concept. That should be clear in the paper. That is very important. So these are the outcomes of citation analysis. You want to know the top guys. Suppose a candidate is doing literature review after the PhD registration. The student, the research scholar, should be able to understand, necessary to able to understand who are the top authors in the citation analysis. I mean, who are the top authors in the area? To reveal the intellectual structure of the concept. So you can reveal the intellectual structure of the concept. Underlying researchers, we will get it. Systematic analysis of the concept is possible. Content analysis is possible. So now we have so many tools for content analysis, you know, that NVivo used for the text analytics and content analytics. Similarly, we can use the content analysis through citation analysis. Future research questions can be developed. Okay. So these are the outcome of citation analysis. Then this is very important, how to set the keywords, recent and impactful papers, go with the definition and concept, inclusive way to go with the literature. If you reached in halfway but your keyword is not good enough, redo all these steps again. So we have collected some data, raw data from the journal index, and we did and after that, we experienced that the keyword set was wrong. After the citation analysis, we have understand that the keyword set was wrong, so that we have to redo the steps again with the correct keywords. Otherwise, we will be misguided. Hence, the selection of apt keywords is the best strategy to do the citation analysis. Okay. So database to do citation analysis, we can take either Scopus or Web of Science or IBDC index. So do first to understand which database is suitable for you. You have to search simply Web of Science and Scopus whether the database is available. So there is a rule of thumb that if your topic is new, go for Scopus, because Scopus, I said that Scopus is an ocean, a lot of journals, a lot of papers. You will get lot of big data from this corpus. If your topic is already researched, go for Web of Science. Web of Science, you will get standard journals. Web of Science is much better index as compared to Scopus. So stages of citation analysis. The purpose of doing citation analysis, know the tools and methods, formulate your strategy and execute it. So I will explain all these tools and techniques, okay, because lack of time. This is a model of citation analysis, data loading, converting, descriptive bibliometric analysis, data reduction, network metrics creation, mapping, etc. we are using here. So this is simple. This model is not difficult. This model is very simple when you understand this thing. So the scheme of analysis, Web of Science, bibliometric data. So after from the Web of Science, you will get bibliometric data, and we can do performance analysis and science mapping. So there are tools we are using, Jeffy, VoSphere, RStudio, and PageX. There are other tools, R, Publish and Perish, BibExcel, Usenet, VoSphere, PageX, Sitespace, His site, Scholar Meter, etc. These are other tools. You understand this is a huge area of research is based on this. So this is a paper which is written based on the bibliometric analysis. Means the tools of bibliometric analysis clearly explained in this paper. This paper written by Massimo Aria and Corrado Cucurolo, and I will explain this bibliometrics through RStudio. So bibliometric is an open source tool so that you can be easily Apple with Windows, Linux, and Mac platforms. So it was programmed in R language to be flexible and facilitate integration with other statistical and graphical packages. So you might have experienced R have a strong interface with the state data, SPSS, and Gretel, etc. So R is compatible. So indeed, bibliometrics is a constantly changing science, and bibliometrics has the first flexibility to be quickly upgraded and integrated. So you can find the research collaborations, and also it will increase the importance of research collaborations in this kind of purpose. So after citation analysis, you'll be able to understand the collaboration network of others. So you know the fact that collaboration is very important in research nowadays. So without collaboration, we will not be able to publish papers, okay? So I will show you how to do this. I have already explained in this citation analysis in my YouTube channel. So you can go to the YouTube channel also. Okay. So first of all, you have to download RStudio. I think many of them have RStudio always already. So here two packages. So first one is bibliometrics. Just click on the bibliometrics. And there is another package comes up after when you click bibliometrics, that is BiblioShiny. Soon after when you click the BiblioShiny, some other window will come up. So this is a package of citation analysis in RStudio. So here you need to upload the data. So here import raw files. I have uploaded some data. I will show you the data. So this is a data. This is a data on a concept. Now I am using a concept called integrated reporting. So this data I have downloaded from the Web of Science Index. So this is a raw data I have downloaded from the Web of Science Index. Okay. So this data I am trying to upload RStudio. Just browse it. So data is here, other file format, and upload, and click start. Time. So the data has been uploaded here. Data has been uploaded here. So the 500 data sets which I downloaded from the Web of Science, I have uploaded here. So you can get the Excel copy of this document. This is an Excel file of your data, your bibliometric data. It contains author's name, article, title, everything is there. Okay. So this also you can use for the literature review. Okay, we can go forward. So data set is there. So data set, you can check the main information of the fundamental aspect of your data set. Your document consists of 500, and out of that, 186 journals and 1310 keywords, and the period 2007. All those 1,256 authors work for these 500 documents. And this is a report of the data, and you can see the citations. Citations of the 500 articles, 2010 to 2020, the citation has been increasing drastically. Okay. And sorry, it's not working. Then here are the most relevant sources of the integrated reporting concepts. You can see that Journal of Business Research is the top journal who publish more paper on integrated reporting. So I just take an example of integrated reporting as a keyword and collected the data and uploaded the data in the R Studio. And after this analytics, I can understand that Journal of Business Research is the top journal in this area, and the Strategic Management Journal, Journal of Business Ethics, Journal of Intellectual Capital, Management Decision. These are the journals who are prominent in these areas. Okay. Then here, Bradford's Law. This is, you can understand the core sources. Out of the so many journals working in this area, these journals are very prominent. This Bradford's Law telling about the core sources of this concept called integrated reporting. Okay. So here, Journal of Business Research is number one rank. You know why number one? Its frequency is 25. 25 papers published in integrated reporting. Okay. So that the Journal of Business Research comes first. And Strategic Management Journal, who secured second place because of 22 papers published in integrated journal, integrated reporting. The Journal of Business Ethics, 19 papers. All these journals are ranked based on the number of papers published in the keyword that is integrated reporting. Okay, so you can see the all these journals here and frequencies. You can see all the journals in your data, how many journals published in journals, etc. You can understand. Okay. So that is a source. Then you can see. So I cannot, I don't want to show all these things. I can show you some important things, the most relevant authors. So here, Humphrey Jenner M. and Wright M. is the top authors in the integrated reporting. And below that, so many other authors. So in the table, the Humphrey Jenner M. has published 4 articles. Okay. And Wright M. has published 4 articles in this area. So 4 articles published in the Web of Science, that is very important. So these people are very prominent. When you do literature review, we should not exclude the name of these two authors because they are very prominent in the integrated reporting. So we should have given the citation to these authors. Okay, there are others, you can find that 3 papers published. We definitely give citation or credit to these authors because they have published more papers on the integrated reporting when you prepare a paper based on integrated reporting. So now you have some more insight, I think. So this is authors' production over a period of time. This is not working because some of the things may not work because of the problem of data. this is Lodka's law. I already explained Lodka's laws in the previous slide. The relationship between the authors, documents, returns, and authors. This shows the relationship between the authors. Then you can see that the authors' affiliations. So the most prominent authors are affiliated to the universities such as University of Texas, University of Zaragoza, Indiana University, all American University. You can see that. So University of Texas, Austin, 11 articles published based on this particular term called integrated reporting. Then University of Zaragoza, Indiana University. So a lot of universities you can see that. And the number of papers published. This is the author's affiliation to the universities. So you may experience that some authors have an affiliation to the universities or colleges. So this is affiliation of authors towards the universities. Now we can understand which university have more content on this particular area. Okay. Then this shows the corresponding author's country. There are corresponding authors when you submit papers in the journals. They will ask for the correspondent authors. So above science also, there are journals in the metrics and there are some correspondent authors there based on the integrated reporting. 500 data we have collected and these 500 papers, this shows the corresponding authors country. You can see that USA is very dominant. Spain, United Kingdom, these countries are very dominant in the publication of papers in the theme of integrated reporting. You can see India's status here. It's not much far below. India comes in, I think, 10 or 12th position. Okay. So integrated reporting for this theme, integrated reporting, India is also performed well. We can see that. So country scientific production. So this is country scientific production. And you can see that out of the 500 papers, 287 of USA is far, far better. So UK, Spain, China, Italy, we can see the India's position. India, only 14 papers published in this area, integrated reporting. So the keyword of integrated reporting in India, only 14 papers. Okay. So most cited countries, I can skip this. Then you can see the document, most global cited documents. So these documents, these others documents are more cited. So you can get the citation. UNISM 2010 and long range planning. And this paper has more citations, that is 470 citations. And Force NJ 2017, 39 citations. And these authors get more citations. Okay, nowadays citations are very important. So this paper has got more citations, 470 citations. Am I audible? Am I myself audible?
Yes, sir, you're audible. We can hear you.
Okay, okay. Thank you. Most frequent words, this is very important. The most relevant words used: performance, value creation, management, corporate governance, innovation, firms performance. So these are the most frequent words we have to give the keywords while uploading papers in the journals. So these are the keywords used by the authors. This is world, this is very important. So integrated reporting, the keyword I searched in the web of science, and I have collected the data. And after analysis, I get to know that value creation, corporate governance, firms performance, corporate social responsibility. These are the key words. These words should be acted as constructs or variables in our research. So when you do an empirical research, these words should be acted as constructs. Okay, so this is advantage of citation analysis before a literature review. So scholars doing literature review, they should compulsorily do this process because they will get to know that more important, relevant words, these words can be act as a construct. Okay. So this is a tree map. I think before the registration of a title, we have to check a citation analysis of your title with the keywords. Then we can understand the most prominent keywords and you can reframe the title accordingly. Okay, so this is the best way. Nowadays, some of the scholars using this technique, before the registration of title, they should undergo the process of citation analysis and understand the most prominent keywords, and they can reframe or redesign the title. Or they can design the title according to the most prominent keywords, because the keywords are important to get more citations. The authors searching, because I searched integrated reporting and I have got some keywords, most frequent words. So these words acted as a constructs in my questionnaire. So here the tree map, you can see there are many word tree map: performance, value creation, management, impact, firms performance, innovation, ownership, governance, creation, market, etc. This is very important for preparation of questionnaires. This is word dynamics. If you see the table, you will understand more. The performance, it was repeated 8 times. And value creation 5 times, management 5 times, corporate governance 6 times, firms performance 2 times. So finally, you will get more understanding on the area. That is an outcome of citation analysis. So trend topics, recent topic. So you will have an insight on this recent topics: corporate governance, corporate social responsibility, knowledge, agency cost, information, shareholders value. So these are the recent topics published, because year by year you can see that 2019, it's like business performance, firms market value, empirical evidence, takeovers, okay, CEO overconfidence, shareholders activism. These are the major trending words. So 2017, based on that you can make a proper review paper based on this. Okay, hope you're understanding. So this co-occurrence network, here you can understand the network of keywords. Okay, so performance, value creation, this network shows the co-occurrence of keywords and the connection of keywords. Okay, so here you can understand the most important keywords of integrated reporting: value creation, performance, okay, corporate governance. These are more, because this network is more vibrant, because all the network connected with this network, because majority authors use these as keywords. Okay, I have seen that many of the papers based on this co-occurrence network alone. And schematic map. Here you can get the, when you click on impact, 59 papers used, financial performance 56, corporate social responsibility 55, firms 40, determinants 26. This connection is there: value creation and the connectivity strategy, the keywords connectivity. So here you can see that. All information is very vital for developing the further process of research. Because all these 500 papers which comes out and published in the Web of Science journal, because of a lot of efforts have taken by these authors. And these efforts have taken in the period, during the period of 10 to 15 years. And these efforts can be captured. And you can make a proper direction from this database. This is thematic evolution. And this is factorial analysis. I think this is not good. And this is co-citation. Historiograph. Okay. So here you can understand the prominent papers based on the chronological order. And this is collaboration network. So here you can see the collaboration network. You can see a search based on the ID, different scenario you can help to understand. The table will give more pictures, okay? And this is collaboration world map. It's collaboration, Argentina, Mexico, Australia, Argentina. It's collaboration countries, Australia, India. So you can understand the collaboration of countries. So all this information you will get after citation analysis. Okay. I think this information is very vital for the development of the further process of your research. So this I have posted in my YouTube channel. You can search my YouTube channel and you can subscribe also. You will get a lot of information. Okay. Because so here I stopped and So reviewers are asked to evaluate a manuscript. Reviewers, when you submit papers, they will be giving importance to originality and significance of the contribution. So your research topic always like this, follow this criteria: originality and significance of contribution, interpret to research community and practitioners, international relevance, coverage of existing literature, satisfactoriness of methodology, analysis and comprehension, clear, concise and jargon-free writing, organizational structure. You should follow these kind of criteria definitely, otherwise it will not be published. And when you set the thesis also, you can definitely follow. When you set the title also, you should definitely follow these criteria. So we are in the process of editing some journals. So this is a link of journal. You can submit it. International Journal of E-Business Research. And I am also ad hoc editor of International Journal of Business Analytics and International Journal of Applied Management Sciences, InterScience Journal. So hope you benefited out of my lecture. I'm stopping this because the time has been reached. So any queries you can ask me right now.
Thank you, sir, for providing us such an informative session. Any queries, participants?
Hello, sir.
Hello,
yes.
Sir.
Yes.
Sir, I'm Bhargavi from SRM University.
Yeah.
So I wondered, you can use the software BiblioShiny. It's available free of cost for internet
Free of cost. First of all, you have to install RStudio. RStudio is free.
Sir, this is Deepashree Chatterjee from West Bengal. Am I audible, sir? I just have one question. Actually, in this lockdown, most of us are confined to our homes and we cannot get access to libraries and all because they are not allowing externals. So in this situation, sir, if we want to proceed with our research, because this is a good time where we can do the research, almost since 1 year, the libraries are being closed down, more than a year. So how, because these Scopus Index channels, we cannot go through directly. They are not available free of cost and the charges are very high for each paper. So how can we, can you suggest a database which is free of cost?
It's not like that. Journal has two options, open access and closed access. So you can still download the open access purpose.
Sir, very few papers are open access papers. Most of them are, you know, paid. Very good papers, mostly they are paid.
Final year.
Some of the papers are open access and some of the published. They are giving open access privilege to all the papers because the time is locked down. So for the academics, all these things. If it's not possible to download papers, you Hello? Am I audible?
Yes, sir, you are now audible, sir. We can hear you.
Okay. So I think there was a lot of disturbances.
Yes, sir, everybody started unmuting and asking questions to you.
Okay. So please conclude that because... So any more questions?
Yes, sir, we will conclude it.
Yes, please conclude.
Gratitude is the most elegant form of courtesy. I would like to call Lalita Bhairavi of First MCOM to deliver the vote of thanks.
Thank you, Kirtana. Gratitude is the sweetest thing in a seeker's life, in all human life. If there is a gratitude in your heart, then there will be a tremendous sweetness in your eyes. A very good morning to one and all present here. I privilege to propose the vote of thanks on this occasion. I would like to express my sincere gratitude to Management Principal Dr. S. Padmavati Ma'am, Vice Principal Dr. S. Rukmani Ma'am, Head of the PG Research Department of Commerce Dr. C. K. Deepa Ma'am, our department faculties for giving us the opportunity organized to informative workshop. My heartfelt thanks to our resource person, Dr. A.V. Biju, for sparing a valuable time and inspiring his precious knowledge with us. I'm grateful to convene of this workshop for the tireless efforts in the making, even grand success. My sincere thanks to technical team for creating the links for the session, drafting the invite. Last but not the least, I would like to thank the participants of their eager enthusiasm and for making this event grand success. I kindly request all the students to fill the feedback form in the link provided chat box before exiting the meeting. Thank you.
Participants, kindly fill the feedback form. It will accept your feedback till half an hour. After that, it will not accept. So those who fill the feedback forms will get their e-certificate. Thank you.
So thank you for the opportunity given to me. Thank you, the college authorities and accuracy authorities, principal, vice principal, accuracy director, and the coordinators of this program. Thank you all. Thank you so much. Can I leave? Can I leave?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you, sir. Can we end the session?